Bhartahari. This Bhartahari, he was a great king, and one day he decided to renounce everything. So he renounced his kingdom, renounced his wife, renounced everything, and he left and was staying in a forest. And once it so happened that he was taking bath in a river. Now, when you take bath, you need to keep your towel somewhere. So he was just hanging the towel on a branch of a tree. Now, it so happened that when he came out after taking bath, he saw there's another sage who is also hanging his towel on the same branch. So both of them got into an argument, and he was like, I came here first and this is my branch and I'm keeping the towel here. Why do you have to keep your towel here? And then the big argument started between both of them. And then there was a simple washerwoman who comes to the riverside to wash clothes. And she says to both these sages, you both are saffron clad sannyasis, renunciates. Why are you fighting over a simple place to hang your towel? Just see the example of our great king Maharaj Bhartahari. He has so much renunciation. He has left his wife, children, kingdom, everything. And see, you are in saffron clad and you are fighting over a simple place to hang your towel. But she never knew that he is the same King Bhartahari, because you see, those days there is no Google to check images, so they don't know. And then Maharaj Bhartahari felt, oh my God, it's true. I gave up my kingdom, I gave up all my riches, but I still could not give up the sense of proprietorship. You know, you get attached even to a place where you hang your cloth, or a simple place where you sit during a Sunday feast class, or a simple blanket or a pillow, you just get attached to just about anything. So then he realized, and out of shame, he hung his head and he walked away. So devotees are Advesha, Sarvabhutana, Maitra, Karuna Evacha, Nirmama, Nirahankara. What happens? In English there is a saying, pride comes before fall. So the moment pride enters, we know what's coming next, fall. You know, so we have to be so careful. We see in the pastime of Ashvashira and Vedashira, both were exalted devotees. They were doing tapasya, but they got into an argument, you know, where for a space, and then their egos clashed and they started swearing words on each other and they ended up cursing each other. And what happened? Ashvashira and Vedashira were such exalted devotees, but they ended up getting a birth in animal species. One of them had to become crow, Kaka Bhushandi, and one of them had to become a snake, Kaliya. So just because of that ego clash, such exalted devotees had to come down to the level of an animal. So that is why Krishna says, I like those devotees who are nirmama, nirahankara. And then in the last line, he says, sama dukkha sukha shami. So those who are devotees, in every situation, they are sama. They are equipoised. When there is happiness in their life or there is distress in their life, they are equipoised. So
Krishna, Krishna, Krishna lage sab Krishna, Krishna, Krishna lage sab Krishna, Krishna, Krishna lage sab Krishna, Krishna.